The very important aspect that you spoke of is regional cooperation and Afghanistan. Could you elaborate on how are the two sides really going to discuss this situation and the issue of Afghanistan? Also, terrorism is a concern for India. So how are the two countries really going to talk about and speak of the issues?
Well, naturally, well, Afghanistan is a matter of our common concern. There are multiple platforms where the two of us, Russia and India, would cooperate. There are very important bilateral tracks of interaction, be it interministerial, Ministry of Foreign Affairs to Ministry of Foreign Affairs, or bilateral interagency tracks. There are multilateral platforms, naturally, first and foremost, United Nations, where India would now be a part of the Security Council. The Shanghai Cooperation Organization, for example, and its content group on Afghanistan. There is a separate platform, separate devoted, targeted platform. And then newly emerging formats, the Delhi Dialogue convened very recently here on November 10, with the presence of the national security advisors of the regional countries. There, the famous Delhi Declaration was announced, reflecting our common concerns and our common commitments. As far as the coming visit is concerned, I could guess for today that the two leaders and the two sides would revive their commitment to peaceful and secure Afghanistan and would revitalize several priorities. Among them could be inclusive government, bringing together different points of view and different political forces. Fighting terror and drug trafficking, securing Afghanistan as a predictable place friendly to its neighbors, extending humanitarian assistance to Afghanistan, preventing humanitarian catastrophe, which in itself could be a source of terror and drug trafficking, and naturally, last but not the least, securing the rights of women, of children, of minorities. This is exactly the agenda which brings Russia and India together, making our effort to secure the future for Afghanistan still more important.
Ambassador, sir, you also spoke about strong military cooperation and meetings between the two sides. S-400s have begun to come to India. We are looking at great cooperation on that front. But when it comes to the waivers, we've only sought waivers for the contracts that were signed earlier. What happens to the future cooperation between India and Russia on the S-400 front?
Well, Gita, this contract is really a matter of our pride, which would testify to the very special strategic nature of our relationship, despite of any kind of pressure or sanctions. This is true about Russia, and this is true about India. Our Indian friends would say that it is our sovereign right to determine our partners in the military technical cooperation based on national interest. This is very much the same with us. As far as the future of our military and technical cooperation is concerned, I would rather reserve my comments till the outcomes of the coming meeting of the Military and Technical Commission on December 6th. But what is clear for now is that the two sides are actively working upon the next decade program of military and technical cooperation. A very sizable and convincing document covering our such areas of cooperation as air power, navy, land power, air defense, and many others. and many others. What is special is that we do currently bring into our military technical ties quite a new approach. This is not a simple buyer and seller relationship, but this is a joint production and joint development of weaponry based on the principles. So rest assured, let's reserve the specific comments for professionals. But rest assured, there is ample scope for cooperation in this field, originating in our common commitments for peace and stability around our borders.
Thank you so much, Ambassador Nikolay Kudashev, for speaking exclusively to India Today. That was the Russian envoy to India speaking exclusively to India Today. It is going to be a very important meeting between the two sides. It is a meeting and partnership that is going to look at peaceful cooperation, but also a formidable one at that.